So, obviously, you are the veteran of the franchise. What would you say is your favorite trap from across the years, if you had to pick just one?
In Saw 3, there are some pigs that fall from the sky into a vat, and in the vat is a judge. I thought that was incredibly inventive and visually stunning. So I like that trap a lot. It was surprised me, and I thought it was revealing of John Kramer's head, what he was thinking about. There are some traps in Saw 3D that I think are, particularly in 3D, overwhelming. I saw the film very recently, and I was impressed with two or three of the traps in here that are just, I know Saw fans are going to really be impressed with them.
You have a lot of input into the Jigsaw character. Is that satisfying for you? I mean, you get to sort of add little things, write little things in when you can.
Yes, it's satisfying. I just care about him being as, I just care about him being as real or as rich as he can be, as credible as he can be. I like things to feel like they're happening for the first time. And it's been a real collaboration with directors and other actors and producers. And I think the films have gotten better as a result of the good attitude that everyone's had in terms of entertaining multiple ideas and selecting the best ones.
So, do you think Saw 3D will be a fitting send-off, and the fans will appreciate some of the little extras they're being thrown, questions answered, that sort of thing?
Yeah, I mean, there couldn't be a better marriage between the 3D technology and a Saw film, which is very related to mechanics. You know, the Saw films are all mechanics, and 3D likes mechanics. And I think that fans are going to get what they come to a Saw film for, which is to be terrorized and to have a physical experience in the theater. And I look forward to talking to them after they've seen the film and finding out what people's reaction is. I think it's a fitting wrap-up.
And you personally, what would you say is your biggest fear personally?
My biggest fear? The stupidity of human beings, I think, scares me more than anything. We continue to make the same mistakes that we have made for thousands and thousands of years. We try very few new approaches to things, and people are still suffering, and the stakes remain the same. It seems to me that we haven't learned a lot from our history, and we don't seem to be making much progress in terms of the amount of cruelty we seem to be able to, parsing out.
So, for you, what is next? Do you have things
Comedy.
lined up?
Well, actually, I'm going to do the Paul Reiser Show, which is a new show on NBC this coming month, and I'm moving on to. I'm going to play a guy who likes to dance and has a real love for life.
So, final question, what will you be dressing up for Halloween this year?
It's more the kids that get dressed up. I don't usually get dressed up for Halloween. We just usually go have dinner with friends, and then the kids get dressed up, and we go out and walk around and watch them indulge their greed when it comes to bags and bags of cheap candy.